Thank you. Professor Bai has left this message explaining why he had to leave yesterday for an important event in China. I read the message. Chinese Academy of Sciences plays an important role in China's space mission. This coming Friday will witness the recovery of the Chinese Shenzhou 11, which includes its separation from Tiangong Space Lab, returning and welcoming our two astronomers. As president of Chinese Academy of Sciences, I need to attend the event in celebrating another landmark achievement of China in advancing global space sciences. My best wishes to TWAS and all of you for a nice journey back home. Professor Chun Li Bai.
Thank you very much. The program will flow as follow. I will make some introductory remarks, followed by Professor Hassan, and Professor Murenzi, and Professor Sood, before calling on the minister to make the final closing statement. So let me start by saying, Honorable Minister, fellow scientists, ladies and gentlemen, friends, the old ones and the new ones, we have reached the end of the 27th TWAS General Meetings. And for me, this is always a bittersweet moment. It has been a rich and productive week, full of lively presentation and discussions. Now, as we come together one last time, it is natural time to reflect. It seems to me that this has been a very special and unique meeting, and this for two reasons. First, we are reminded that TWAS is extremely fortunate to have such good friends. Rwanda has offered us a warm welcome and generous hospitality during our stay in this very beautiful country. For this, we owe profound thanks to His Excellency President Kagame. For this, through his patronage, we have been able to spend a wonderful time in this world-class convention center. By his presence and his commitment to science, we are encouraged to work hard and achieve excellence so that we can contribute effectively to our shared goal of prosperity and peace among nations. I'm deeply grateful to Minister Musafiri for his generous support to this event and his friendship to TWAS. He has been most generous with his ideas and with his time. Honorable Minister, thank you for joining us again this morning, as we may thank you. Over the last three decades, TWAS best work has been always done in partnership with allies and friends who share a vision of scientific strength in the developing world. So we are forever grateful to the Italian Ministry of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation. And we are glad that some of our Italian colleagues and friends have been able to join us this week. Thank you very much. We are thankful as well to the Swedish International Development Cooperation, and I hope that you all realize what a vital relationship this is for TWAS and for scientists in Africa and throughout the developing world. SIDA's commitment to our work over many years has literally changed the course of history. Thank you so much. We also count among our closest allies the Kuwait Foundation for Advancement of Sciences, and more recently, our partners at Lenovo, the global technology company, the Elsevier Foundations, and the Academy of Science of South Africa, whose support has injected a powerful new energy to our entire organization. Thank you very much, friends. This meeting has been special for a second reason, because we are meeting in Rwanda. And we have seen up close the vision that has guided its achievement. Think of it. This country has come so far on a long and difficult road. 30 years ago, Rwanda was among the poorest country on the continent. And in the 90s, it endured a tragic of historical proportion, a tragedy of historical proportion. But today, this nation is rising thanks to the vision and leadership of the President Kagame and the hard work of the people of Rwanda. Rwanda has become a role model for African nations and even beyond for other least developed countries. We have seen Rwanda's emerging scientific strengths throughout this conference. In the health and nutrition research TWAS medal lecture of Professor Gahutu, in the excellent presentation yesterday morning on the Rwanda science, in the confidence of Rwanda scientists and science leaders, and the decision by the Carnegie Mellon, the ICTP, and other to make deep commitment here. We see this future vision in the establishment of the Rwanda Academy of Science. We see it also in the intelligence, creativity, and hard work of the Rwandan staff who have managed so effectively all the event of this week. It was wonderful to see them working so hard with the TWAS team in a natural spirit and of cooperation. Thanks to the Rwanda team. But progress requires to see clarity of the whole reality. There is still so much to do in Rwanda and across Africa. You have probably heard that sub-Saharan Africa will need 1 million new scientists in the decade to come to work across all sectors. But we are lagging so far behind in producing the PhD needed, and we are nowhere near to the 1 million target. We believe that the World Academy of Science has a critical role to play in helping us to answer to the need for more qualified scientists and scholars in Africa through its PhD scholarship, postdoc research fellowship, research grant programs. Its global network can provide us with a fantastic platform for the education and training of our scientists. We are convinced that the Academy and its partners from all the regions are ready to help us. At the same time, though, Africa knows that the major effort to lift up this continent will have to come from the Africans themselves. By working together in a united front, we can and we will do it. The message I would like you to take back home is, yes, we face a challenge, but don't write us off because we are coming. Thank you very much and hope to see you very soon. It's now my pleasure to call on Professor Hassan.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Professor Touré. And good morning, ladies and gentlemen, Honorable Minister. Thank you so much for being with us in this final session, the closing ceremony. And we're very delighted to see so many of you still here. I was very worried, and I was talking to my colleagues that we might not get so many people in the final session of the meeting. But I'm really very delighted about that. Well, Honorable Minister, the 27th General Meeting of TWAS, the World Academy of Sciences, was indeed the culmination of months of careful planning and consideration, both on the side of TWAS and also our local host here. We have been very busy in the past 5 days, and we have accomplished a great deal. In the process, we have created a new community of scientific cooperation that will draw this country, Rwanda, and its scientific community, and the World Academy of Sciences closer together to the mutual benefit of both of us. Well, during the last 4 days, we have held the scientific discussions on topics, various topics ranging from strategies against global epidemics, policy for sustainable development, social sciences for social justice, and the importance of probing the universe. At the same time, and this is really the purpose of my presentation here, we can report significant accomplishments in two areas. Firstly, this meeting has established a vital new connection between Rwanda and the global science community. The World Academy of Sciences now has over 1,200 members, representing more than 95 countries. And now, more than ever before, Rwandan scientists and policymakers will be linked intimately into our network of the most accomplished scientists in the South and in the North. Indeed, this has been an auspicious week for science in Rwanda. The Rwandan Academy of Sciences was formally launched just before we arrived here. We have met with the Academy's leadership, and we have pledged to introduce the new Academy to the world of academies of science, both globally and at the regional level. These networks are very, very critical, and through these networks, Ugandan scientific community, the best of Ugandan scientific community can connect to the best of the scientific communities worldwide, not only in the developing world, but worldwide. And this is a very, very significant event. The symposium, Science and Technology Rwanda, that featured 9 researchers and policymakers with detailed presentations on advanced work, including internet and communication, technology, anti-malaria efforts focused on pregnant women, innovative efforts to manage the pollution that comes from abandoned mining sites, and various other issues that were raised. This symposium gave leading global scientists an impressive view, a very impressive view of the research work being carried out in Rwanda. In fact, we're beginning to realize that there is a wealth of science in this country that we never realized before. That session was really very, very critical and important for the Academy. And we are going to feature some of these beautiful presentations made by the scientists in Rwanda in our website and through various publications of TWAS. Further, our meeting in Kigali for the first time gave TWAS a chance to meet the Rwandan science community in person, especially the young scientists here. And our program coordinator, Max Pauli gave a presentation to the Rwandan scientists, especially the young scientists, on the various programs and activities that TWAS is implementing for the benefit of scientists in the developing world, and especially in the least developed countries, including Rwanda. So this is quite important, because there are so many opportunities, as you all know, PhD fellowships, postdoctoral fellowships, research grants, a large number of activities. So that as far as Rwanda is concerned. The second is decisions, and very important decisions, emanating from the TWAS Council and general meetings. And I just highlight three of those. The first is the election of new members of TWAS. The TWAS Council and general meeting elected 40 new members. Now, what is important about these 40, the number is not so significant, is the fact that 30% of the 40 are women. And this is the first time in any election of TWAS that we elect 30% from our distinguished women scientists in the developing world. And they come from 18 countries. So that, for us, is quite a significant event. The second is the establishment of the TWAS Young Affiliates Network. Again, this is a very, very significant event that took place here. And this is a network that brings together the young affiliates of TWAS. They are going to be linked together for the first time and to be provided with a platform through which they can establish programs and activities and connect to other young scientists, organizations like Young Academies, the Global Young Academy. But what is so important about this, I think this is really the nucleus for the voice of young scientists in the developing world, because it's going to expand. Currently, they have about 125 young affiliates under TWAS, but the number will expand every year, because they will be linked through various networks and various alumni of young affiliates, alumni of TWAS. So it is a very, very significant network, and fortunately, the Lenovo, the company in China, the IT company in China, will support this network and support the activities of the network. So that is the second very significant event. The third one is, and again this happened here, is the approval of our fifth strategic plan. And that has been approved here, discussed and approved here. And that is the most important document that TWAS has as a guide for TWAS and its activities and evolution for the next 4 years. So TWAS will carefully follow the strategic objectives and directions of the strategic plan for the next 4 years. And that, again, is something very, very important, and we are very happy that the endorsement of this plan took place here in this meeting. And of course, we have accompanied to this, again, a detailed fundraising strategy that we hope will enable TWAS to raise more funds from the global community, of course, mainly from the South, but we are reaching out also to the advanced countries. Well, Honorable Minister, colleagues, this has indeed been a very rich and rewarding meeting. It has inspired admiration for the scientific work that is underway in Rwanda and throughout the developing world. Further, it has renewed our hope that through our commitment and constant hard work, science will make essential contributions to a healthier planet and stronger, more prosperous communities in Africa and across the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Professor Hassan. Let me now call on Professor Murenzi to say a few words. Don't need any presentation, but.
So I would like first of all to thank the minister. During the transition between myself and the Professor Mohammed Hassan, on the directorship of TWAS, he really helped to make sure that this conference continue as we were doing the preparation. So I would like to really to thank the minister for that. If you could give a good thank you. Because when I was appointed, I didn't know because how things will move as I was in Paris and my colleagues in Trieste. But during the transition, the ministry and his team helped to continue for the preparation and of the meeting. Number two, TWAS is one of the main arm of UNESCO together with ICTP and other Category 2 Institute of UNESCO and other network in building scientific capacity, in particular in the developing world. As Professor Touré just mentioned it, the issue related to PhD is very, very central. I just say it over and over again. We may complain that we don't have quality education in higher education, but that doesn't change. You may put any program related to quality assurance. If you don't increase the number of PhD, it will not work. The South Africa Department of Science and Technology realized that there was a challenge on that issue and commissioned a study by the South African Academy, the Academy of Science of South Africa. And that study came about, showed the challenges that the educational system, higher education system in South Africa was going through. And they put up a program. Thomas may correct me, I think until 2030, to train a certain number of PhDs with NRF to give the scholarship, enough scholarship to be able to do that. And that is a very, very, if South Africa has done that, and it is really the in terms of science and knowledge on the continent, is the center. So we think that our countries should be the same. Calculating, looking the teachers in higher education in a country like Rwanda and say, how many of them have a PhD? How many of them have a master's degree? And how many of them have a bachelor's degree? And then say, okay, in the next 10, 15 years, 20 years, will I be able to reach 50% of the teachers with a PhD? Will I be to reach 70? Will I be to reach 80? Where am I going to get the money? So that is something that is very, very central. Because it's not only in the sciences, it's in the natural sciences and engineering, even in the social sciences. We all complain that we have our youth is unemployed. Of course, it how can they not be unemployed? If somebody is, if 80% of the teachers who are teaching somebody in electrical engineering, the person has a bachelor's degree and the guy is going to get a bachelor's degree, the degree he's getting is probably a secondary school degree, but not a bachelor's degree in electrical engineering. In most of the teachers in mathematics at university have a bachelor's degree and a master's. And the teacher, the person who graduates will go to teach in secondary school. This means we have a secondary school leaver going to teach a secondary school in secondary school. I give these examples because this is reality throughout the continent, but also throughout the developing world in general. If you go to Europe, let's say in OECD countries in general, a primary school teachers have to have a bachelor's degree. This means from the beginning already, not only have a bachelor's degree, but he has to have a degree in the area he's teaching, plus education. Not only a bachelor's degree in mathematics, but he has to have a degree in education, probably early childhood development and other, and adolescence and things like that. And then as you move to secondary school, it is the same. You have a full 100%. In the developing world, you will see normally there are many places where the people who are teaching in primary school actually are primary school level or 9 years of primary, of 3 years of secondary school. And they will teach primary school. And that has a big challenge. So going upstream and downstream, the PhD number of professors, the percentage, is a central key to building scientific capacity, not only in the developing world, but across the world. Even the countries in Europe and other are in the OECD, they watch that number because that number is very, very central even for their scientific and technological output. So my mission as UNESCO, as the person in charge of capacity building, is to leverage, work with organizations such as ICTP, TWAS, and other organizations in order to be able to see how that number can be increased. So I'd like to stop here and again thank the minister for having made it possible, and in particular also the president of the republic for really putting what is necessary for us to be here. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Prof. Murenzi. Before requesting the minister to deliver his closing statement, let me call on Professor Su to very briefly.
Honorable Minister Musafiri, Professor Tauri, Dr. Muhammad Hossein, Dr. Murenzi, TWAS fraternity, TWAS friends and well-wishers, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very sure that all of you had wonderful experience over the last few days in Kigali. As very succinctly pointed out by our Vice President, Professor Tore, and Dr. Muhammad Hassan, this meeting has achieved a lot, and it was well summarized. You will all agree that the quality of all the presentations in all the sessions was uniformly very high. So I would like to thank all the speakers for their tremendous hard work put in putting these presentations, and all of you for participating in it. On behalf of all of you, and on my own behalf, it's a pleasant opportunity for me to put on record our sincere thanks to all the people who made this meeting possible. Few people have been mentioned, but now again I'll say that for the sake of records, and I would appreciate if you show your appreciation in the usual way. So first of all, thanks to our minister, Honorable Minister, for a big support and being here in all the sessions. Thank you. It's a pleasant duty once again, to thank the Office of the President team and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs team. Higher Education Council team. I'm not saying the names of all the people in these teams because these names are quite a few, but this keywords which we are saying, it only reflects that we really appreciate the efforts of every member of this team in individual way. Then we thank National Commission for Science and Technology team. We thank Office of Government Spokesperson team, Immigration and Migration team, Protocol team, Celestine Makunza, and the Event Factory team. And we now thank Claudine Uvera and the UR team. And individually we thank Mary Christine Gassin Girva, if they are in the hall, may I request when I say the name, if they stand up, we can appreciate more. Mike Hughes. Flora Motezegazu. Juliet Niera Nenza. And the Mind Duck team. And in the end, last but not the least, I would thank the TWAS team, because this team works in the background over months, and the preparations start very early. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank all this team, which is ably led by Dr. Mohammad Hussain right now, and earlier by Dr. Roman Murenzi. So let me now, I read the names of this team, and may I request them to stand up, because all of you are in the background, really the unsung heroes, and we would like to appreciate your tremendous work put in making these events successful year after year. So I'll read Sandra, Helen, Patricia, Antonella, Ed, Max, Christina, Gabriela, Tonya, Gusto, and of course, once again, Dr. Roman Murenzi and Mohammad Hassan. So friends, I'll just close my Thanksgiving, but usually it is a convention. On the last day, we announce the venue for the next meeting. And I'm sure you must be all waiting for it, but I'm very sorry that we have to disappoint you this time, because we have not yet converged on a venue. It would happen, hopefully, in the next few weeks. We are in the process. But at this time, I would like to take this opportunity that if any of you, any of the members, have some suggestions or some influence to suggest some names where possible avenues could be considered, I'll request you to send us an email to our executive director, and we will follow that. So we would look for your help in converging on a venue for the next meeting. And we hope that this can happen in the next few weeks. So with this, I close, and I wish you a very safe journey back home, and look forward to seeing you in the next meeting. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Wood. Mr. Minister, once again, thank you for gracing this closing ceremony. On top of all the thanks for what has been done before this closing ceremony, and I would like to invite you to give us your closing ceremony. And in our African culture and traditions, after the minister talk, nobody else talk.
Honorable Professor Mokito Turi, the Vice President of TWAS, distinguished representative of the government of Italy, distinguished representative of UNESCO, Professor
Romeo Mrenzi, a representative of Swedish International Development Agency. Their entire team of TWAS, starting with you, Honorable Secretary General, Executive Director, Professor Mohammed, members of the board, and the entire membership of Executive Committee, fellows and members of TWAS, distinguished representatives of the government and the academic institutions of Rwanda, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I greet you all. On behalf of the government of Rwanda, I'm pleased and honored to be with you at this closing session of the TWAS General Meeting of 2016. I've seen that much has been achieved, and as it has been pointed by several previous speakers, in the last couple of days, ever since this conference was officially opened by His Excellency Paul Kagame, the President of the Republic of Rwanda. The endorsement from His Excellency of this event underscores the importance to Rwanda of being requested to host such a prestigious science event. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I express my thanks to the team of the World Academy of Sciences, led by Executive Director Mohammed Hassan, and the national organizing team, led by, as it has been mentioned, by Mike Hughes and Dr. Marie Christine Gasinzigwa, but leading a very big team and constituted by so many institutions and individuals from Rwanda, which we don't have enough time to mention, all of you. So thanks once again to both teams, worked tirelessly and in close collaborations to ensure the smooth running of the meeting, which I'm sure you will appreciate, has led to success of this meeting. However, we tend to apologize whenever we might have fallen short of expectation. Next time, we shall do much better. I sincerely thank Professor Bai, the President of TWAS, Vice President for Africa, Mokta Turi, and the entire TWAS management team for having had the confidence in Rwanda to be the host of this event. And again, thank you. And again, as Professor Romeo Mrenzi mentioned before, want to thank you very much, because this journey started when you were still at TWAS. But even when he joined UNESCO, he continued to be a source of influence and support all the way up to this very moment where he's sitting at the closing session of this meeting. So thank you very much, Professor Romeo Mrenzi. As I highlighted at the outset of this meeting, the benefits of bringing such an important global science meeting to Rwanda are abundant, given the importance the leadership of Rwanda has pressed on the necessity to raise our capacity in science, technology, and research. This is in support of addressing the many challenges that we face as a developing nation. We recognize the opportunities that TWAS has to offer to scientists and scientific institutions in developing nations, such as ours, through the many programs and initiatives of TWAS, which deliver benefits including PhD scholarships, postdoctoral research fellowships, research grants, exchange visits for scientists and researchers, regional conferences, prizes and awards, as well as witnessed, as we all witnessed through the days of this meeting. Through this meeting, we have already experienced recognition in our developing pool of scientific talents. In this regard, we appreciated the opportunity availed to Rwanda to deliver a 2-hour science symposium on the third day of the meeting. This gave the international science community present in this conference a chance to sample of the research being undertaken by Rwandan scientists. This provided a window to look into the culture of science and technology and scientific research being undertaken in Rwanda and the ambitions that Rwanda has in this area. I hope there will be more opportunities for one-on-one collaborations with our young scientists and researchers. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I particularly thank TWAS again for providing time in the very packed schedule for the meeting to devote a session to educating our Rwandan scientists chosen to participate in this meeting on the specific details of what TWAS can offer in support of their career development and their scientific institutions that they represent. The presentation contained many practical details of how they can apply for these TWAS awards and how to maximize their opportunities for success in these very competitive applications. Many of the possibilities can benefit our young scientists in Rwanda, and two very practical examples I have seen are, first, for the Rwanda science community to find some very talented young scientists who can be nominated to apply through the TWAS regional office to become TWAS young affiliates, which I know is a very competitive process. Secondly, the partnership currently being debated between the African Union Commission and TWAS to develop a young scientist award, which Rwanda will be delighted to join once the final details of the program have been finalized. And the third, it is the debate conversation which shall lead to the partnership between the Rwanda Academy of Sciences and the network of academies represented in this conference. We are also delighted with the generosity and support from one of the TWAS award winners. Before I conclude these remarks, I'm pleased to highlight the very important step that has been taken in Rwanda to establish a Rwandan Academy of Sciences, RAS. The establishment of the academy only 1 week before the meeting was very timely. The TWAS meeting provided the opportunity for the leaders of RAS to discuss with the management of TWAS how our fledgling academy can become affiliated with TWAS. I'm convinced that this affiliation will enable the academy to rapidly develop into an organization that will provide a significant support for the capacity development of scientists in Rwanda in support of our nation's economic and social development. Thank you. Thank you. This TWAS 27th meeting is now drawing to a close, as the SG mentioned that there ought to be more talks or speech after this one. But I hope that many of you will be able to stay longer in our country and enjoy many of the delights and the attractions Rwanda has to offer. So please, don't leave until you find it very, very necessary. I thank you for your kind attention. Thank you.